We're on the Mount of Olives now, just outside the gate of the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus prayed, where he sweated blood, where he was betrayed, denied, and finally at this place he was arrested.
We're entering at the gate now of the Garden of Gethsemane. Ancient olive trees, beautiful flowers, it's a very beautiful place where Christ often came to pray, to meditate. Olive trees probably 2,000 years old or more.
And there's a possibility, and a very strong possibility, that beneath or around some of these very same olive trees that we see here, Jesus himself sat or stood with his disciples. You know, Jesus knew his divine purpose right from the very beginning. And that last night of his life here in the Garden of Gethsemane, he knew that his hour had come. He was born human, just like any of us, and he didn't want to die. He prayed, as a matter of fact, he prayed to be spared the death that he knew was very near. Here within a very few feet of where I'm standing, Jesus stood. And when they came to arrest him, he said, "I am he whom you seek." And they took him away. If Jesus had not had a divine purpose in dying, he, through his divine power, could have been delivered, as it's indicated that he delivered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from the fiery furnace. Many, many years before the time of Christ, King Nebuchadnezzar looked into the fiery furnace and saw that the three men were walking around in the fire. And he said of a spirit that was there protecting them, "The form of the fourth is like the Son of God."